I told you that this guy invented a little device used by billions of people every day but never made any money out of it? Oh! His invention? Well, the computer mouse, which evolved from this to this. But can all of these be considered a mouse? How many types of mice are out there, and which one is the best? And most importantly, why didn't this guy become the richest man in the world? Invented as a post-war military secret and launched commercially in the late 1960s by Douglas Engelbart, this little device went from being a curiosity at a computer conference to conquering the world during the 80s and 90s. How did it achieve that? Well, like most things, by mutating and adapting. The first mouse was mechanical. It was carved out of wood and had just one button. But what's fascinating is how it was able to track movement in the simplest but most ingenious way. The mouse has a big heavy ball at the bottom, similar to this one. When you moved the mouse on the table, the ball rolled, making it slide relatively easily. But the magic was happening inside. Let me show you. When the ball moves, it rotates these two little roll bars on the sides. They are strategically placed at 90 degrees to track the X and Y movement. Then, that input was sent to the computer, and the cursor moved on the screen accordingly. The most annoying thing with this design was that these roll bars would get filthy, and you had to clean them constantly. And that's because the ball picks up dirt from the table and deposits it into the bar, jamming the mechanism and messing up the motion tracking. Fortunately, compared to other peripherals like the keyboard, the mouse evolved significantly more. The first design iterations happened during the 80s and 90s. A second button was added as well as the scroll wheel, but it wasn't until the 2000s that we saw the first huge evolution. With the introduction of the optical mouse, we could say goodbye to maintenance and hello to accurate motion tracking. Over the last two decades, optical sensors have become better and better with ever-increasing DPI. But what's fascinating is that the mouse didn't stop evolving there. It has mutated into a wide variety of species. Some have developed many buttons, others decided to live upside down. So before putting on our explorer's hat and finding out about all the different types of mice and their features and benefits, let me talk about one important concept: the grip. There are three main ways to grab a mouse. First, we have the palm grip. This is the most common grip, with the whole hand on the mouse. Next, we have the claw grip. That is resting just the back of the palm on the mouse and fingers in an arch position. Last is the tip grip, with, you guessed it, just the tip of your fingers resting on the mouse. The grip is important because it affects how comfortable a mouse feels when you use it. So keep that in mind while we enter the fascinating world of mice. And to help in our adventure, we have our in-house mouse explorer. Let's start with the basics, the conventional mouse. These are the most used type of mouse on the planet. So these are both Logitech computer mice, and Logitech alone claims to have manufactured over 1 billion mice. There are many variations in shape, price, and materials, but we can group them in three subspecies: symmetrical, tilted, and very flat. But none of them are highly ranked in ergonomics. Okay, first we have the symmetrical mouse. This is a standard Logitech mouse that came with a keyboard bundle. What's interesting about this mouse is that it can be used by right and left-handed users. The shape is suited for a claw grip as well as a fingertip grip. It has a versatile shape that can be used for work or gaming, but your hand is heavily pronated. And when you're in this position, long hours of the day, it can lead to strain on your arm and also your shoulders. We can talk about that more later when we talk about the vertical mice. Next, we have this Superlight Mice, the Logitech Pro X. These mice look like regular mice, but are extremely light. That makes moving them on the desk much easier, which is especially useful for reducing finger fatigue. However, weight is not the only thing that affects how easy a mouse is to move around. You also need to consider the surface you're sliding it on. Of course, this doesn't fix the hand pronation problem we mentioned before. Next, we have the very flat models, like this magic mouse. What a lot of people like about this mouse is that it has a minimalistic design, and personally, I find it very beautiful. Beautiful, aren't you? A lot of people like about it is because of the integrated scrolling you have on the X and Y axis. I would only recommend this for users with a tip grip that don't use the mouse a lot though. And even so, you should be mindful of your arm position and overall body posture when using this mouse, because gripping this mouse from above can lead to elevated elbow and shoulder strain. And last, we have this Logitech G703. This is tilted to the right, as you can see, for improved hand position and faster left click response. This shape is designed with a slope for hand rest and a convex hill for support. It can only be used by right-handed users, unfortunately, although there are some models tilted the other way. This is suited mainly for palm and claw grip users, but not ideal for fingertip. You can use it for gaming and working, but the hand is still heavily pronated. To fix that, you need to get a vertical mouse.
I don't know how you did that.
Here we have the Logitech MX Vertical. This bad boy has great ergonomics because it keeps the hand in a handshake position and displaces the movement to the elbow. They're great for most work situations, but not so good for certain types of gaming. For example, for FPS, move the mouse while shooting and you really feel that you're tensing your thumb just so you can click constantly. Plus, many vertical mice have crappy sensors. When choosing a vertical mouse, there are many things to consider, like hand size, shape, the buttons, slope, etc. For a complete review, take a look at this other video. But what if a vertical mouse isn't for you? Is there something in between? Yes, there is. We have a sculpted mouse. This is the Logitech MX Master. I would say it's like a tilted mouse on steroids. It has exaggerated features like a higher and more angled palm rest and sometimes extra buttons. It aims to place the hand in a better position without affecting muscle memory as much as a vertical mouse. However, it still doesn't solve the pronation problem and it adds other problems. For example, you need to watch your pinky finger, as you can see here, because dragging it on the desk is not good for ergonomics and it's just not good for your pinky in general. Pobre the pinky. They're also pretty tall, so they can cause a bit of wrist extension. Wrist extension, by the way, is when your wrists are in this position, which is a big no-no. I would only give this a go if you tried a vertical mouse and you decided that it wasn't for you. This could be a good option. That'll be all for mice, but what about other pointing devices?
Like my finger.
Speaking about fingers, the trackball. What's interesting about trackballs is that they require no arm movement. It's just the finger action. Since the hand doesn't move, it avoids harmful wrist movements that you do when you use, for example, this mouse. So there are two types of trackballs. We have the thumb trackball and the finger trackballs. Let's start with the finger trackball. The example I have here is the Kensington Orbit Fusion. You use your index finger to move the trackball, and this model has a variety of shapes and grips, although none of them avoid hand pronation, which we mentioned earlier is a big no-no. It's important for you to choose the model with the right size. For example, this one is small, and I think for those who have big hands, they would devour this mouse. It's also very important to find a model that has reachable buttons because the range of movement of the finger is limited compared to the hand. And next we have the thumb trackball. This is the Logitech Ergo M575. And since the thumb has a wider range of movement than any other finger, making it faster but a little bit less precise for small movements. These are usually tilted as well, so your hand is not completely pronated. With this mouse, it's best to use it with a palm grip. Although trackballs have their share of fans, they also have their drawbacks. If you have a huge screen and you want to move fast across it, you might need a really fast pointer speed, but then you're not as precise for things like design or photo editing, or in some cases, just navigation. I would recommend them though for people with wrist pain that are coders or typists, but not designers or video or photo editors. And last, we have the trackpad. We're very much used to them on our laptop, and this allows for different hand gestures. However, they're not very precise. Things like dragging and dropping are complicated. When you use a trackpad, your hand is, you guessed it, pronated. And there's a lot of wrist movement, so that's also something that we want to avoid. I would only recommend them as a second input device for hand gestures. Nothing more, nothing less. Conclusion and goodbye! And there you go. All the different types of mice, each with a ton of models to choose from and its own sets of pros and cons. I'm sure there's one just for you and your use case. I know I have my mouse. Before we finish, let me just say thank you, Mr. Douglas Engelbart. Your creation was ingenious and visionary. Unfortunately for you, it didn't make you the richest man in the world. It was so ahead of your time that when we actually started using it, your patent had already expired. Sorry, Douglas. And to you, my fellow digmates, I say, find that perfect model that will bring joy to your clicking and scrolling adventures. Happy mouse hunting. In the late 1960s by Doug. There are three ways to grab a mouse. First, you grab them by the neck, and then you grab them by the tail. I'm kidding. That was great. Yeah. Cut.